You know, sometimes I don't know why I do these things to myself. So I had a couple of people comment saying I should come back to this game. So I sent out a tweet. Probably should have increased the like goals, but regardless, here it is, a one-off video of the worst Call of Duty ever created. Now, I don't care that Vanguard exists or Modern Warfare 2019 with the constant camping and ghost that stays active whether you're moving or not. This game is worse, and I will explain why in this video. You know, I thought I was gonna hate working on this video because obviously I had to get the aids that comes with launching this game just to get gameplay. But then it hit me. I'm not partnered with Call of Duty. I can rip this game a new asshole without consequence. So, let's begin. Why did I hate this game? First, the perk system. This alone was enough for me to stop playing. After the fourth month that this game came out, I don't think I touched multiplayer at all after that. I was just playing DMZ. I will not spend a single second in any Call of Duty game without Ghost. That's not me saying that I want to camp, but I want to be punished for firing an unsilenced weapon or sitting in corners. In this game, they brought over Ghost from Modern Warfare 2019, and they completely made it a one-to-one recreation. They did not balance anything or make any changes to hamper the players that are abusing Ghost. You could sit still. Whether you were firing an unsilenced weapon or not, your dot would not appear on the radar. It was so infuriating because you would walk in through any door and you would have someone in the corner with a shotgun and a riot shield ready to take you out, even if you had a UAV up, because you couldn't see him because Ghost was keeping them from being spotted. And even the people who are fine with the game mechanics, they don't like how every single week the playlist would change. There's a lot of people that just stop playing because their playlist option isn't available. Ever since they added the quick play feature, I get that it's supposed to streamline matchmaking, but I still just want to search for one single game mode. I don't think I've met a single person who honestly selected multiple game modes inside of quick play. I think we just searched for one mode. Also, I'm a hardcore player when it comes to getting camos. Don't forget that they completely fucked us over with tier 1. Along with the whole shadow ban thing, games crashing, poor performance, servers would lag constantly. Packet bursting was a huge issue, especially on PC. Console players had that issue too. Not as bad as PC people. It made ranked a living hell to play. Modern Warfare 2019 was put on the map with its new movement system, the incredibly loose movement with slack canceling and bunny hopping, which spawned all of the TikToks and movement montages and clips and stuff like that. They hamper you for movement in this game, completely penalize you. You are forced to do the entire slide through its duration. You can't cancel it. It's like the Call of Duty Ghost slide, but a little bit faster. It took them 5 seasons to even completely refine the movement because we complained for so long that the slide was too slow and completely killed your momentum. And they did fix it. They did make it speed up a little bit, but it's still just a really broken slide that you can't cancel at the end of the day. So there's almost no point in doing it. Modern Warfare 2, it was a whole year of just learning how to jump peek corners and stuff, because that's basically all you could do with this movement. Modern Warfare 2019 honestly felt like a death by a thousand paper cuts. It was trying to do a reboot to kind of be a fan service type game. The maps in that game sucked. They were one of very many bad things about that game. Some of the maps that launched with later seasons weren't so bad, but this brings us to Modern Warfare 2. While this game has better maps, they're still not anywhere near as good as the best Call of Duty maps ever. We have basically no movement, useless minimap, terrible spawns, the UI being a Netflix menu, which we did find out later that the guy that made the Hulu UI was actually brought in to make the UI for Modern Warfare 2. Gunsmith, completely overcomplicated. We had 70 different barrels to select, 70 different muzzles, optics. It's a complete mess. Pick 10 shits all over the gunsmith system. We have a lack of any proper new content after launch. That's where Sledgehammer has gotten their praise for Modern Warfare 3, is because the post-launch content has been incredible. Look at all of the skins that they've come up with, the new maps, all of the organic and fun game modes. And then you come back to Modern Warfare 2, and it's just the most linear experience you can have in an FPS game. It's terrible. I also just realized I can't talk about Gunsmith without mentioning the weapon tree, so level the MP7 to level 15 to get a muzzle for this gun that you can unlock at level 20 by leveling this gun to... Good lord, who came up with this shit? While we're on the topic of guns, the gunplay is so bad. There's either slow handling or awful visual recoil. You had no strafe speed outside of SMGs. You know, this is Call of Duty. We should have fast and snappy handling, and guns should feel satisfying to use. Like a fighting game. We need that instantaneous button response. No dead silence as a perk. Footsteps were so loud, aggression was completely punished. And that was detrimental to the game, especially given the fact that so many people play on PC now, and that brings sound EQ into the equation. So that's also becoming mainstream. Maps are terrible. Strongest aim assist in Call of Duty history, by the way. All of the skill was taken out of a core FPS mechanic on one input, and all of the other inputs that are actually skill-based were completely nerfed because of this. The aim assist was completely busted, so strong. If you look at any, like, gameplay and slow it down, you can tell. Even on the smallest setting, it is way, way too sticky. It is terrible. You can gather a laundry list of all of the bad things about this game, and that doesn't even make me mad. What makes me the most upset is the fact that this was the highest grossing Call of Duty on launch, I think in like the past 15 years, or in the franchise entirely. I don't remember which one it was, because I'll have to pull up the tweet, but this just goes to show how absolutely gullible and stupid the Call of Duty fan base is. They will believe anything that is told to them without even seeing proper gameplay. The second the trailer comes out, all you gotta do is mix some AI edited cinematic cutscenes and gameplay and stuff like that, put it over like Motorhead Ace of Spades, and they're like, oh my god, this year's Call of Duty looks like the best one yet. The next game comes out, actually no, the last one was better, and then the cycle keeps repeating. So I don't have that anymore, because the last couple of Call of Duties I haven't even bought myself. I got Modern Warfare 3 from a subscriber of mine. I got Modern Warfare 2 2022 from a friend of mine who had it for about a month and then gave it up to me because he hated it. And now I hate it. Now I'm stuck with the disc because nobody else wants it. And when it comes to Black Ops 6, I can be grateful that Microsoft has purchased Activision, because I have Game Pass. I don't need to pay for a single Call of Duty from here forward. The only exception to that would be since I collect games. A couple of years down the road, I'll probably pick up some of the games that I've missed out on disc. And that'll be okay, because they're not getting my money immediately like they would be if I was buying or pre-ordering, like buying the disc on launch, that sort of thing. So I'll be in the clear when it comes to that. Plus, are we completely ignoring the fact that Sledgehammer gave us everything that should have been in this game? You know a Call of Duty is bad when for the following release they have to stick in the same universe and change everything that was ruined by Infinity Ward. They had to undo all of this crap so that way we would get what we wanted. Slide canceling is back. Bunny hopping, kind of. But all of the changes that were undone by Infinity Ward are finally brought back for Modern Warfare 3. It's still not a good game in some people's eyes. I think it's okay. It's probably a middle-of-the-road Call of Duty for me. We could have had this originally if Infinity Ward just listened. That just goes to show how incompetent they are and how they basically should not be allowed to make another Call of Duty game. Give it to Raven. They have never made their own Call of Duty game, and they're working on all the stuff for Warzone. Imagine what they could cook up if we gave them the full control over a single game. Like if it was a one-off game, or make them work on Modern Warfare, see what they could do. They need to start filtering out the other dev teams and letting people in. Keep the established people like Treyarch and Sledgehammer, but start filtering out the people from Modern Warfare, or have them make their own series or one-off game. Like, we still have yet to see Call of Duty Z. I want to see a zombies-only COD game. Let Raven develop that. Let's see what they got. Regardless, I've gone on for far too long. This is my tangent brain trying to defer to like different topics and stuff like that, as it usually does. So this is why I hate rambling, but a rant like this for the worst Call of Duty game of all time, I think, is warranted. So yeah, this game dead in the water, worst COD of all time. Vanguard tops this, and I never thought I would hear myself say that. Anyways, guys, if you agree with anything I say in this video, drop it down below in the comments. I want to hear your opinions on why you think this is the worst COD game of all time, or if you're one of the crazy people that somehow believes that this is not the worst game of all time. But you're more than welcome to debate in the comments below. Anyways, if you enjoyed, drop a like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, share the video with a friend. All the support helps the channel greatly. I will see you all in whatever video I upload next. Take care.